coming up on Shawele Road.
What is the message of shameless audacity? What does it especially mean when it comes to praying dangerous prayers? What is it to pray a dangerous prayer anyway? Is it shouting loudly, "Father, Father"? Now, in this message, I'm going to share with you the testimonies of many people who, through prayers that I have prayed together with the saints, they have had a sudden filling of the Holy Spirit. Some have been healed of cancer. Doctors have received jobs after being jobless for 7 months. And still others have had loved ones released from prison. Now, dangerous prayers can do all of this and more. And the Lord has given me an understanding from the prayer examples of people like King Solomon, from Mary, the mother of Jesus, from Elijah, the fiery prophet, and from the Lord Jesus himself. Now, this message is especially anointed by the Lord because when I preached an early version of it to one of the original listeners, he said as he heard it, he saw a vision of the Holy Spirit as if he was hovering over us, just like he hovered over the waters in Genesis chapter 1. So I know that this message, if you hold on to it and make it your own, especially the testimonies, the Lord will do for you the same things as he's done for the people whose testimonies you're going to hear. And I know the Lord wants to release a fresh anointing for you. So come along. Now, who am I, you might ask? I am Dixon Mosake. I am a servant of the Lord Jesus, and the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach to everyone everywhere that repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near. Now, the Lord has chosen me from among my brethren, and he has given me his oracles, including this message, which is part 9 of a 12-part series called Under Your Wings, which is testifying about the Lord's great, great deliverance. In this ministry, we also love our Christian brothers and sisters, and if you listen to this message until the end, we feature a sister ministry which focuses on receiving testimonies and verifying them. Now, additionally, this message is only a small part of the full revelation that the Lord Jesus has given me for you. But if you visit our website at shaweleroad.com/underyourwings, you will receive the full revelation. And now let's get on to the message of shameless audacity. Now, Luke chapter 11 introduces us to the idea of shameless audacity, or audacity, whichever way you choose. And then it goes on to show us that dangerous prayers have a pattern. Here is the story. Then Jesus said to them, "Suppose you have a friend, and you go to him at midnight and say, 'Friend, lend me 3 loaves of bread. A friend of mine on a journey has come to me, and I have no food to offer him.' And suppose the one inside answers, 'Don't bother me. The door is already locked, and my children and I are in bed. I can't get up and give you anything.' I tell you, even though he will not get up and give you the bread because of friendship, yet because of your shameless audacity, he will surely get up and give you as much as you need. So I say to you, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives. The one who seeks finds. And to the one who knocks, the door will be opened. Which of you fathers, if your son asks for a fish, will give him a snake instead? Or if he asks for an egg, will give him a scorpion? If you then, though you are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father in heaven give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him?" Now, audacity is a word which means willingness to take bold risks. So shameless audacity is a willingness to take these bold risks without a fear of being embarrassed. Now, that is pretty critical, because it means in this story The man who was asking his friend, mark you, his friend, he was shameless. He just kept on knocking, lend me three loaves of bread, lend me three loaves of bread, lend me three loaves of bread. He was bold and shameless to the point of embarrassment. His friend opened and gave him what he needed. And this is the perspective that the Lord is giving us for prayer. Do you have shameless audacity to pray and pray without giving up too soon? And here is another part you might want to see. This story is also showing us that by comparison, for us human beings, we are wicked. We might not even be such good friends like the man in the story. But God, He is a great friend, and He will give to anyone who asks, persistently and with shameless audacity. So, this story is introducing us to persistence in prayer. But now, what is dangerous prayer? So prayer is not dangerous necessarily because of style or voice, shouting like I said, Father, Father, rolling on the ground. Now, it might be well and good to do these things, and don't take this as criticism of one style over the other. No, you could actually be overcome and desperate enough to pray in that style. But a prayer is dangerous for one simple reason. It is dangerous because God answers it. And so a pattern of dangerous prayers is when God answers your prayers again and again. Now, I myself didn't even realize that I prayed dangerous prayers until the Lord actually Himself showed me this, because I was actually getting discouraged. I'd been praying for a while for something, and I wasn't getting the answer. And then the Lord showed me that while I was getting discouraged, He has been using me to answer hundreds of others' prayers. And this encourages me that He will in time answer my prayer if I have shameless audacity. And He used this opportunity to then let me share with you some of the things He has taught me about shameless audacity and about dangerous prayers. And in a great book that I wrote about dangerous prayers, you can actually get it completely free from our testimony.org. The Lord showed me the examples of King Solomon, Elijah, Mary, and our Lord Jesus about dangerous prayers. What can you learn from each of these great examples? Now, Solomon, most of us would not typically associate King Solomon with dangerous prayers. We would probably think of him as the wisest king, the richest king, the one with 700 wives and 300 concubines. And yet Solomon knew how to pray dangerous prayers. Now think of it. His father David had written the Psalms, which are the prayer book of the Bible. So Solomon definitely knew how to pray dangerous prayers. But how did I know this? Now, there is a pretty dangerous prayer that Solomon prayed when he dedicated the temple to God. And this prayer is in 1 Kings chapter 8 from verse 22 to 61. And it is pretty long. But the Bible shows us that when Solomon finished praying this prayer, fire came down from heaven. Yes, fire came down from heaven. You might know of Elijah and fire coming down from heaven, but you might not know that when Solomon prayed, fire came down from heaven. Now, what is the lesson you could learn from Solomon's dangerous prayer if you get to read it? One of the things you could learn is that if you follow the ancient pattern of prayers, you will get results. Now, some of these ancient patterns of prayers which I have studied when I've studied the Psalms and which Solomon used in his prayer include this. One, starting with praise. Number two, reminding God of His word. And that is why reading the Bible is so critical, because then you can remind God of His word. Three is being humble, and four is to actually make specific requests of God. If you imitate these patterns, you will get results just like the ancients did. And now let's talk about Mary. Now, Mary, the mother of Jesus, was so dangerous in prayer that when she entered the house of her relative Elizabeth, Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit as soon as Mary greeted her. The baby in Elizabeth's womb, John the Baptist, leaped with joy when Mary greeted her. Imagine that. An anointing so powerful that a simple greeting can bring the Holy Spirit down. Now, here's the secret. The reason that Mary had this anointing is because she was constantly in the presence of God. Now, why did God always admit her into his presence? There's a secret. It's because she was humble. If you read Mary's dangerous prayer, which is called the Magnificat, it's in Luke chapter 1 from verse 39 to 45, you will see that Mary uses words connected to humility at least 5 times. Now, why is humility so critical for praying dangerous prayers? The reason is this. In many verses, we see that God hates the proud and he keeps them far. So the ones who are humble, he brings near. It is those who are in his presence who get his anointing. And this is the kind of anointing that brings the Holy Spirit down just when you speak. Now, think of Mary. She could have been the proudest person in the world because she could have thought, I'm the holiest woman of all time, past, present, future, because I was chosen to carry the Lord Jesus. But you know what Mary did when she prayed her Magnificat? Here are the first words that she said in her Magnificat. My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has been mindful of the humble state of his servant. What humility. And now let us talk about another man who brought fire down from heaven. So most people know Elijah as the fiery prophet of God who challenged the prophets of Baal to a contest and he caused fire to come down from heaven. They also know him as a man who never died and he went to heaven in a chariot of fire. What you might not know is that Elijah was also a man of persistent prayer, which is a form of dangerous prayer. So the Bible shows that Elijah prayed a dangerous prayer, which was pretty effective because of perseverance. And this story is in 1 Kings chapter 18 from verse 41 to 48. A very interesting passage in that verse says that Elijah told King Ahab, go get something to eat and drink. I hear a mighty rainstorm coming. And do you want to know what Elijah did after he said those words to King Ahab? He actually went up on a mountain to pray for that very rain he had declared to come. What is crazy about this is that Elijah actually prayed the first time and nothing happened. And then he prayed 6 more times. And on the 7th, when he saw a tiny rain cloud, the sound of a fist, he then quickly ran down the mountain. And under the spirit, he outran a horse and a chariot that belonged to this King Ahab. This prayer was dangerous. You know why? Because Elijah persevered. He had shameless audacity. Do you know the secret to perseverance? The secret to perseverance is that God had already given him the answer, so he knew that rain was going to come. So a dangerous prayer is not because of persistence just for the sake of praying. It's because you know the answer. And no wonder the Lord Jesus said this. Therefore, I tell you, whatever you ask for in prayer, believe that you have received it and it will be yours. So therefore, in dangerous prayers that are persistent, we know the answer. And what we are doing is, if we are not seeing this in the physical, we are then not just continuing to ask. So if you're praying and you've believed and God has already answered, but you don't see your answer in the physical, don't keep asking, oh, give it to me. No. The Lord has showed me that what you do instead is that you shift to thanksgiving, and you keep on giving thanks and celebrating what God has already done, what you saw in the spirit, until it is manifested in the physical, just like Elijah did. And now let us see the example of our Lord Jesus. So the question is, why did God always answer Jesus? And I know this because our Lord Jesus said something very dangerous before he raised Lazarus from the dead. When he prayed to God in that prayer that is in John chapter 11 from verse 41 to 42, he said this, Father, thank you for hearing me. You always hear me. Now think of those words. You always hear me. Why did the Lord God always hear Jesus? It's not necessarily because he was a son of God. Not necessarily. The scriptures say this. During the days of Jesus' life on earth, he offered up prayers and petitions with fervent cries and tears to the one who could save him from death. And he was heard because of his reverent submission. Now imagine that statement. The Son of God is offering prayers to his God. And do you know why his Father hears him despite the tears, despite the cries? So think of it this way. You're crying, Father, Father, you're rolling on the ground. God does not necessarily hear you because of that. God heard him because of his reverent submission, his awe of God. Therefore, fearing God, holding him in reverence, worshiping him, treating him with honor, remembering he is a great king. That is what causes him to hear your prayers, just like he heard his son Jesus. So therefore, if you fear God, he will answer your prayers. And that is our final dangerous prayer strategy. Now, we've heard of dangerous prayers, we've heard of the strategies, but how has God proven this in his testimonies to me? Let us talk through some of these testimonies. So earlier this year, the Lord Jesus got me to lead a Bible class of over 250 students. He then got me to start a secret intercessor group from within that larger class of 250 students. What would happen, and what still happens, because the class is not over, is the classmates will submit to me prayer requests. I would pray over them privately, and then I would share them with the secret intercessor group, which is about 40 people. The testimonies that have come out of that class and that secret intercessor group are unbelievable. I'm going to share with you just some of these, which are the fruit of those dangerous prayers. Testimony number one, cancer gone, whose report shall we believe? So this is the prayer request I received January 19, 2024. I was tested and told I have cells that will result into cancer of the cervix. The news blew my mind. I know since you are in the desert crying and making straight the road for people to know God, the Lord can hearken to my prayer as well through your voice. So this is the testimony report I received 18th of February 2024, which is exactly 1 month after the prayer request. My brother, whose report shall we believe? First test, no cancer, not even a slight sign. Two consultants handled me with over eight other doctors. I am overwhelmed. Thank you for your prayers. The Lord has humbled me. And then she ended it with emojis of lots of tears crying. Second testimony, my brother has been released from prison. So the prayer request came 30th of May, 2024. This is what it said. Praise God, Pastor Dixon. I'm writing to ask you to pray for my brother. He had a business partner and they were trading in cars, but his partner swindled a client's money. And because his partner has some police officials he knows, my brother was taken to prison. This is Luzira prison in Uganda. I know God is the rightful judge and I'm asking that you stand in the gap for him tomorrow. We're going to court so that they can release him on bail. The testimony after the secret intercessors prayed with me fervently the very next day, this is what the person testified. Praise God, Pastor Dixon. Today in court, it all went well. He was released on bail. It turned out that the magistrate went to school with my other brother. I called that favor. Generally, it took us less than 10 minutes to be out of there. We thank God for the favor. Testimony number three, the Holy Spirit came to my daughter suddenly. This is the testimony. My testimony is that last time as my daughter was helping me to get the Bible link for the Bible reading plan, she spoke to you, man of God, to help out. The Holy Spirit entered her like magic. And all of a sudden, she also started reading the Bible. She quickly got the link and started reading the Bible. And now she is so serious. Every day she asks me, have you finished? I wish this would be the starting point of her salvation. Praise be to God, Sarah M. The fourth testimony is a doctor with no job for 7 months. Here is the prayer request. Good evening, sir. I have a prayer request. The Bible says that our confession is our possession. I have made it a habit to always confess and believe that good things will happen in my life. But of late, I have sat down to reflect through, and I have noticed that every time I confess a thing, even if it's halfway done, somehow it dies. Could there be anything wrong with me? I am a medical doctor who qualified 7 months ago, but up to now, I am still struggling to get a job. Could you stand with me in prayer as I believe God for a job? Thank you so much, my brother. The answer to this testimony also came 1 month after we started praying. This is what the testimony said. Good afternoon, my brother. I thank God for the prayers we made. I now have a place that I am working at. It was only God. Now, those are just examples of some of the testimonies. And if you visit our website at shaweleroad.com under your wings and you find Shameless Audacity, this message, you'll find I've written another five other examples, just as examples of the hundreds of answered prayers. Some of the testimonies you'll find there are this one here, someone worried about exams. And in general, they were worried. In fact, they said it is getting out of hand. The Lord took her worries away as she read the Bible. Then God saved me, Pastor Wasake, from a car accident during the winter. I was driving at over 70 miles an hour. Oh, that's about 100 kilometers per hour in the winter. And my car, with my family, five of us, skidded off the road, and nothing happened because somehow the Lord sent his angels to carry us, including out of the ditch where the car had fallen after the accident. Then another person wanted debt from her life and she owed taxes to the authorities in Canada. God gave her a refund and she even paid off one of her credit card debts in full. Then an uncle owed her a debt from over 2 years. She feared asking the uncle for money back because of family ties. Then just suddenly, he gave her back 80% of the debt and she used this to also repay credit card debt. Someone else, I had prayed for this person for 2 years because the Lord had given me a dream of this person, showing me this person at the end of time, or what they call the rapture. I prayed for this person for 2 years. Eventually they joined the Bible class this year. They were actually one of those who finished the Bible in 1 year. In just 5 months, the Lord put a fire in them. They didn't even know I had prayed shamelessly for them for 2 years. Then a lady got a long-awaited UK job, and still another whose mother is an alcoholic hurt her with her words, terribly hurt her. She told me she was crying when she shared the testimony. Guess you know what? You know what the Lord did? He gave her peace from all of this. These are just some of the testimonies. And why am I sharing this? Because ultimately, this is a message of Jesus. The scriptures say this: worship only God, for the essence of prophecy is to give a clear witness for Jesus. So what I am doing in sharing these testimonies is I am bearing witness together with all these brothers and sisters who have shared their testimonies. I am bearing witness that the Lord Jesus is alive and well, and he's operating in the lives of loads of people, those he loved. And this is the exact reason why the Lord Jesus came. He said he came to destroy the works of Satan, the works of the devil. He came to this earth and died for our sins so that he could do that destruction of the evil one. And I want to praise God for all those testimonies, for the Spirit who's working in the lives of all those. And if you believe in these testimonies, you too, the same God who has answered those hundreds of prayers, he can do the same for you. And that is proof that shameless audacity in praying dangerous prayers will bring the kingdom of God near into your everyday life. Now, if you want to be transformed in the same way and you're wondering if these stories are true, the starting point is for you to become a Christian and to receive the Spirit of God, and he will confirm to you that this is true. You can pray this prayer with me to become a Christian. God of heaven, I confess that I am a sinner and have been one since birth, but I've heard that you can make me new, and you sent your son Jesus to die for me. He rose again, and it is he who can give me his Holy Spirit. Please forgive me and welcome me into your kingdom. Teach me how to follow you. In Jesus' name, amen. Welcome, welcome to you who are new believers. I have a few steps for you. Number one is publicly demonstrate your proof of getting saved by getting baptized. This is a means of declaring publicly your acceptance of Jesus, because if you're ashamed of Jesus, he says he too will be ashamed of you before his God and the angels. Number two is start living your life of faith as a Christian. This often starts by reading your Bible. Yes, reading your Bible. The other things is that it involves praying and finding a church that you can join and grow in this church. Now, don't you worry. God, the Holy Spirit who started this work, he also gets to finish it, for the scriptures say that I am with you until the end of all time. Now, if you love our work, we have a great gift for you. If you subscribe to our newsletter at shaweleroad.com, you will get a free book that the Lord Jesus got me to write in that first year. The book is called Holding On to Christ. He also gave me a one-year spiritual guide to share with you. These are steps that the Lord has gotten me to share with you for you to mature in your Christian walk, especially from that first year that you get saved. If you're inquiring and you have questions, you want to know more about these testimonies and what the Lord Jesus can do for you, write to me. If you want prayers because the Lord has anointed me to pray for his people, write to me at dwasake@shaweleroad.com. There's just one more thing left. Whether you're a new believer, whether you're a mature Christian, please stick around for our information notice, but it's very brief. It includes information about that ministry partner who I shared with you about at the start. And so this is your brother in the Lord, Dixon Wasake, a slave of the great Lord Jesus, and I pray that the Lord will bless you and allow you to partake of this ministry of dangerous prayers and shameless audacity. Lord Jesus, come, Maranatha.
And here is the information notice board. Pray for us. Without the Lord, our effort is in vain. Pray that we remain faithful, humble servants. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and keep up with our videos which support the website. Looking for a ministry to partner with? Pray, volunteer, give, subscribe to, consider supporting. The above ministry website has not paid us to provide this recommendation, and so the views expressed here do not necessarily represent the views of the ministry promoted above. Likewise, the views therein do not necessarily reflect those of this ministry. So here are your next steps. I believe.